Hey guys, welcome to my channel. In today's video, I'm gonna be K-beauty breaking it down and choosing two K-beauty trends that I'm sort of experimenting and playing with these days. I'm just gonna be using makeup that I received from APU's opening in SM Mega Mall. So quick fact, me and everyone I know has always called it APU, but when I check the labels, the way it's spelled out is actually OPU. I mean, I want to do things the right way. I want to do things properly, but I really don't know if I can say that with a straight face. It feels so weird and I don't know if I can say it. So if you guys want to take a deep dive and listen to me break down and nerd out, geek out on K-beauty looks and their details, please keep on watching. This is the OPU Juicy Pangwot. Hindi ko kaya. This is the APU Juicy Pang Water Blusher in BE01. That's one layer. It's not really showing up on camera, so I'm just gonna add a few more until it registers like the way I normally enjoy it when I wear it in person. So the Juicy Pang Water Blusher is a sweet, berry-fragranced water blush. In K-beauty, water blushes are liquid blushes with low to high pigment, but the end goal is always never being opaque. So there is a limit to how you can layer it. And while I'm demoing a sheer and lighter color today, the red tints, they don't really look like doll makeup, cakey makeup. It just tends to look like really strong but still transparent color. So while it is typically called a water blush, the texture is much thicker than water, almost like a light syrup. So I like it this way because it helps with blending as compared to something too watery. I use the applicator to load two heavy dots per cheek and blend that out using my fingers before setting my base with powder. The Juicy Pang Water Blusher blends easily but quite sheerly. I try to avoid it when I have dry patches on my cheeks because I find that it sort of clings to the side of those patchy, flaky skin. So it can be difficult to blend when my skin is not that good. Staying power is okay, it's just there. It stays on normally for 2 to 4 hours on me. BE01 is a nude rose that has ultra fine shimmer. It is great for fairer people who want a subtle, non-burnt blush look. I like using it when I want color in my cheek without looking like I applied blush. Similar products are Be by Vanilla Cheer Water Cheek and A Concept Cheek Me Water Tint. Next, I'm going to show you guys the APU Juicy Pang Water Lip Tint in BE01. So the APU Juicy Pang Tint is a water lip tint and is very similar in concept to the water blusher. Korean water lip tints also have low to high pigmentation depending on the color that they've chosen, but they're never really opaque. If you've seen those really bright red water tints, they can be like super duper dark red, but still, they will never get to be opaque. They're still transparent. So the texture of this one is a little bit thicker, a little stickier than the water blusher, which I really like as my lips are always super duper dry and have more difficult texture. So this like oilier, stickier texture helps to calm things down and sort of smoothen things up, which is a great help when you have a thinner lipstick structure and no thick agent to really hide all of that horrible texture. Anything too watery and it's already a pain to blend out, and this is why I've always made it known I have such a hard time and rarely patronize the first generation Korean water tints because they can be super duper hard to work with on my dry and textured lips. So the flat angle tip of this applicator is really good in pushing and blending the product in. It has a very thick gloss feel at first, but it quickly subdues into nothing, leaving only a slightly moist finish. This applies perfectly and evenly. I love wearing this for no makeup looks like today. Apart from my slightly heavier eye makeup, this can really pass for an everyday no makeup makeup look. I love how it is an MLBB both in color and finish. So the transparent quality of the color makes it look super duper natural, and the slightly moist yet not really glossy oily finish makes it look like moist natural lips. So while same in shade name as the Juicy Pang Water Blusher in BE01, the Juicy Pang Tint in BE01 is a much brighter, milky blush rose shade. Like, it's much pinker than what's on my cheeks right now. I like how the extra rosiness sort of counteracts the darkness in my lips and just makes everything look super fresh and super light. So similar products that come into mind right now, Pony Effect Favorite Fluid Lip Tint and Clio Professional Veiled Wee Tint. So let's K-Beauty breakdown. What makes a water tint look? You have a lot of brands offering water tint products, not only on the lips, but they're starting to do it on the cheeks as well. The common quality in all of them is that they're gonna offer you a transparent wash of color. Whether you have a nude color or a very, very bright red color, it's still going to be transparent no matter how much you layer it. Like, your real lips and your real cheek texture is still gonna show. The finish is in between of highlighter and matte. It is just a simple and plain glow. So like water, it's not really super duper glittery, it's not super duper shiny, but if you look at it and just like admire the subtlety of the finish, you will see a little bit of shimmer, a little bit of shine, but nothing overly so. I like water tint looks for lazy days. This is a very good everyday or me but better look. They're so easy to work with. It's not a lot of trouble blending them in. And they don't really look super duper overdone. So if I wear less makeup, it's just gonna go and blend seamlessly with a whole casual sort of easy breezy vibe. I don't really recommend the look for anyone looking for longevity because sheer washes of color tend to dissipate super duper fast, and I don't know if it's just the lightness of the stains that I'm working with right now, but these products don't really leave stains on me. So if you're looking for something much longer lasting, I'd just direct you towards something matte or long wear. Next thing I'm gonna try for you guys is the APU Juicy Pan Jelly Blusher in CR01. So this is about how much I would normally put on my cheeks, but the lights again are washing it out, so I'm gonna layer a little bit more heavily and just have the camera register to you guys what the color and the finish looks like. So when I apply jelly mousse blushes to avoid like the pooling and the pilling of the product, I sort of like pull it out. And then to avoid kind of ruining my base, I sort of slap the edges away. The APU Juicy Pan Jelly Blusher has the same berry fragrance as the rest of the line. Jelly blushers are solid blushes which mush or sort of squish when you press it hard. I like them because I love playing with the texture and I love enjoying the sort of squishy jelly feel. And they don't really crack in your bag like powder blushes. So I take a bit of product using my fingers and I swish on the pan a lot because this product is super duper sheer. I like not to mush the jelly, so I go lightly but briskly, so this lets me pick up a lot of product without really ruining the perfect dome shape of the blush. Like the water blusher, it goes on perfectly on smooth skin but also tends to cling on dry patches. When my skin is not perfect, I also avoid this blush. When my skin is perfect though, I feel that the jelly blusher adds a layer of sort of dreamy, cloudy, smooth perfection on my skin. It makes me look like a walking filter. Like, there's a hazy, beautiful quality to my cheek that, of course, is not normally or usually there. Longevity is pretty similar to the water blush at about 2 to 4 hours. CR01 is as sheer as the water blusher, but it looks more vibrant against my skin tone, I guess because of the orange hues in it. So I really like using this bright coral blushes when I'm wearing fuller finishes or brighter colors of lipstick. Similar products are Innisfree Jelly Cheek and Too Cool for School Jelly Blusher. So next I'm gonna demo for you guys the APU Juicy Pan Mousse Tint in RD01. So the Juicy Pan Mousse Tint is a velvet tint, which is my current favorite K-Beauty finish. Mousse tints or velvet tints are liquid lipsticks with medium to high pigmentation and always matte finishes. Mousse tints often have the added bonus of smoothing out lip lines and kind of perfecting lip texture, which as you know I greatly appreciate due to my problematically dry lips. APU's Juicy Pan Mousse Tint feels the wettest or the most moisturizing among my collection of velvet tints, which include a lot of things. I'll be putting it in the description box. So I like that despite it being more moisturizing, it still retains that mousse. I like that despite being the most moisturizing velvet tint, it retains that moussey, cloud-like, velvety texture. See, it looks like super plush and diffused. So the Juicy Pang Mousse Tint in RDO 1 is a slightly deep, slightly cool red. And I would never think to pair it with a coral blush actually, but I think that put together, it makes my face like really bright, and it's a different sort of color scheme that I don't really sort of gravitate towards too, but now that I see myself wearing it, it's actually super duper enjoyable. So while RDO 1 can layer into a full power lip, I just like to deposit a dot of color and then just sort of spread and press that all around my lips. I don't really like a clean lip line when I'm wearing velvet lip. Diffuse that and just mess it up a little bit with my fingers. So this product stains, so it doesn't actually leave embarrassing lip holes and lasts a respectable 46 hours. Similar products are 3CE Velvet Lip Tint, Peripera Ink Velvet, BLK Soft Matte Mousse, Happy Skin Shut Up and Kiss Me, and Clio Professional Matte Matte Tint. So I guess of all of my velvet lip tints, I enjoy this one the most because it looks the most diffused, it looks the softest, it looks the most like cloud-like. I really like that this is the most moisturizing velvet lip product in my collection because it's been a difficult pill to swallow that with these beautiful matte colors, I've just had to accept the discomfort as part of it. So this being a little bit more moisturizing makes it that much more ideal on my problematic, dry, and textured lips. So let's K-beauty break it down. What makes a velvet look? The velvet look is a pretty unique K-beauty trend because it's really all about the details. It's always getting into that midpoint and not really sticking with something super extreme and yet still doing something slightly more than too sheer or imperceptible. So from a beauty perspective, velvet finishes are somewhere in between powder and cream. So a cream has this like smoothening texture, but it often tends to look wet. But on the other hand, a matte or powder finish will have this really dry or no shine look, which can sometimes accentuate texture. So Koreans typically having quite dry skin, velvet trend really picked up and hit it off because it hit both bases in that the jelliness or the velvety texture helped to hide some of the more problematic dry skin features such as lip lines or cheek texture. So I can understand why this is a super long and ongoing trend. I mean, it really matches their typical Korean skin profile. Like the water tints, there is a translucency to the quality. The pigment content of most velvet finish products are not really that intense. They're not meant to fully cover everything, but to have this sort of interesting play with light that allows you to see like some translucency and yet still have this sort of perfecting silicone-like layer that smoothens out everything and makes you appear like cloud-like and filtered. So those are the two K-beauty trends that I'm spotting a lot in my Instagram feed these days. Overall, they're both really about the details, and that's something that I really appreciate with K-beauty. I love how they really take care and select each and every detail so that everything doesn't have to be too overpowering. With the water tint trend, I like the translucency of the color. I like that there's a slightly wet finish to it, so when I'm wearing less makeup, it's not going to stand out in such great contrast against my lesser done face. On the other end, we also have the velvet trend, which is also playing with a certain level of transparency, but it's not as transparent as the water tint trend. If you wanted it to, you can diffuse it to something really soft or pack it on for more impact. I think just the whole feel of being cloud-like, which is fluffy but not too solid, is a really good trend to play with and wear sometimes. Personally, I don't always like wearing super intense things. I don't like super intense lip products all the time. And I have moods where I want color but I don't want it to be super duper strong. So something like the velvet trend can actually give me a range of color underneath this sort of cloud-like, soft finish. And those are two K-beauty trends that I'm sort of experimenting and playing with right now using products from APU. I don't know, can you guys say OPU? Is it awkward? OPU? OPU. help you. Can you all say it? I don't know. I feel so weird saying it like that. But anyway, like, what do you guys think? Are you team water tint or are you team velvet tint? Let me know in the comments what you guys prefer, and maybe I'll experiment more with those looks. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell icon for notifications every time I post a new video. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye! 안녕!